Are you guys ready for this spaghetti? Here comes some craziness, you guys. Here comes some craziness. Here comes some craziness. Keep your shorts on.
Woo! Snap!
We got mixes happening.
An old friend of the Unstoppable killing machine.
That is BGH Horror. Go check them out. We got one more, and then we will get started up.
Come on, Dad. I'm trying to make a good impression.
It's a lovely night. Walking in the moonlight is very romantic. Trust me.
But, Dad, you promised to let me use the car if I got good grades. Dad, I want to take her to the movies. It'll take an hour to walk there.
Then you better get going. And by the way, enjoy the show.
Cool Man up in the house. Crystal Carter, Green Thumb, Amusing Torture, Resolution, Brett Blaze, Chess Pretzel, Freeloke, Prodigal Brosh, Smooches, Majestic Bones. What is going on, everybody? Muffin Man. He's a man in a muffin. He's out of control. Gas up, Justin. You guys, we're all going to be sitting back in the theater again. Even if it is just the screen in our room. Except we're going to be inside the movie.
Did you Shit's enjoy the movie? Ridiculous. Jason, I'm talking to you.
Well, I'm not sure I really understood it all.
Then let me explain.
Some folks have a strange idea of entertainment.
All right, you guys. It's time to get back in the cabin. Who has not seen the reveal yet? Who has not seen it yet? Most everybody I know that was in the stream with me today saw it. Oh, there we go. Bros Jedi, you have not seen it. Oh my god, it's you has not seen it. Oh, I was like, I can't walk. It's because the controller wasn't picking up. Alright, so we're just gonna go sit down and chill somewhere, like right here in front of the fire. If I could figure, oh, there we go. Red Cat, this soundtrack right here was used on a lot of them. Like, a lot of the ambience you hear from the earlier ones borrow. Like, so a lot of the tracks, they borrow pieces and parts from other tracks. But, all right, you guys, are you ready? A lot of people have not seen it yet. Sweet. All right, you guys, get ready for Friday the 13th. They did a mic drop today, you guys. And it was pretty friggin' epic. So for those of you that didn't catch it, be prepared. Day Bros Jedi, thanks for the cheers. Let's do this. Let's first turn off this music. There we go.
Hi, I'm Tom Savini, and I'm here to introduce you to a world-exclusive video of the new Jason I
Wherever
created.
Wherever the red dots go.
No! The 14th game.
Yeah, we gotta turn these... we gotta turn these alerts off. We gotta turn these alerts off. Hold on. First of all, who donated? Mad Wolf just donated $5. Thanks for the donate. You guys,
hold off on the donations
until we get done here. But I'm going to go ahead and turn off all the alerts for right now, because that will get in the way. So give me a moment.
How sweet.
Man, I am going to have to smack you, Freddy.
The Shadow Witcher, thanks for the follow. You guys, hold off on it. And okay, my alerts are turned off right now, so hold off on that.
How sweet.
That one slipped.
Fresh meat.
Thanks for the follow. Otaku Dragon, thanks for the follow. All right, it should be turned off now. Let me wait a second.
Fuck you.
You guys.
Over.
Damn, Mr. Mooney.
Mr. Mooney does not want me to play this for you guys. All right, let's do this. Let's do this, you guys. Be prepared. I'm gonna wait. Okay, the alerts seem to be gone.
Hi, I'm Tom Savini, and I'm here to introduce you to a world-exclusive video of the new Jason I created for the Friday the 13th game. That's not it. You ready? Here it comes.
How sweet.
Oh my god.
Fresh meat.
Why are they not off? All right, hold on a second, you guys. Why is it not off? Why are these not off? Why are they still on? Oh, here we go. There we go. Okay, I missed one little thing. Okay, now they are off. My apologies, you guys. Let's do it. All right, let's stop for a second, you guys, and think about something for a second. The music faded away. That means that is his chase music. That means this Jason has chase music, which means, and then I will let you guys probably maybe figure out the rest of it. Let's start this again. Now that you know that potentially this is his chase music, you guys, now listen to it again.
We'll be right back.
Fucking sick, you guys. Fucking sick is this? You guys, I played this earlier when I was playing Player Unknown Battlegrounds, and I was like, I don't want to play the game I'm streaming anymore right now. I just want to play fucking Friday the 13th. And there was a lot of dudes. There was a lot of dudes during... A lot of dudes, and more dudes. All right, you guys, you want to watch it again? Of course you do. Of course
you
do.
Hi, I'm Tom Savini, and I'm here to introduce you.
Also, now everybody can know who Tom Savini is, because I swear to God, a lot of people just don't even know who he is. I think some people were starting to think that the Jason was named Tom Savini. So there he goes, you guys. He made it a little bit more personal. That is Tom Savini. I'm glad he actually came up and said something, too, at the beginning of this video. It's really nice.
Hi,
makes
I'm Tom Savini.
Makes it a little bit more personal.
Savini, and I'm here to introduce you to a world-exclusive video of the new Jason I created for the Friday the 13th game. That's not it. You ready? Here it comes.
Surprised, you guys, about people not knowing who Tom Savini is. So completely amazing. Can he teleport indoors now? No, a scoundrel, that was a shift, not a teleport. Two completely different things. Fucking epic of a mic drop was that, though? Now that's all that's left is a release date, you guys. Now that's all that's left. But holy crap. Oh, you need it. Wait, hold on. Did you? Let me scroll back up. Was there a question? Oh, yeah. Shift and teleport to two totally. Hold on, let me get up. Two totally different things. When you shift, it goes into, I don't know if some of you have not seen it yet, but it goes into like an Evil Dead mode where the camera's kind of just floating really fast through the environment, and you can go through. So if somebody's running to a door and you shift, you fast forwarding, zooming towards them, you can potentially just go through the door while they're opening it, and then by the time they get in there, you're in there with them. So yeah, you just have to know how to shift just right. There's a strategy to playing Jason, you know. It's not just going to be an easy trip. You got to know when to shift, know when to, do the right abilities, and know how to sneak up on people really well. Or just intercept them really well. Dude, I'm telling you, Jurin, that The Tom Savini Jason coming after me is going to make me a nervous wreck. A nervous wreck. Kermit. I can't wait. Like, all you guys. Rose Jedi. Like, all you guys are going to be playing. Sugar Trey hopefully will make his way to the PC. Wolf Ninja. Like, all you guys are going to be rolling up in there. It's going to be great. I'm looking forward to it for sure. Kenny, are you looking forward to Friday the 13th? The game? Well. Maybe Kenny, not so much. I don't know, you guys. I wouldn't want to be thrown in a Slayer movie and end up dead in the bathroom every day. How many Deborah Kims and how many Bugsies and how many AJ Masons are going to get slaughtered? There has to be a counter, a statistic, to see how many Kenny Rydells have died, how many Chads have died. Oh, shit. Robbie Charts, what's going on? Uh-oh. Stream's going wonky a little bit. Flow Dog, what's up? Savini with stalking mode. Holy shit. You guys, it's going to be creepy as hell seeing that thing walk around. What is in here? Savini, are you exposed yet? He is not exposed yet, you guys. He is still flaming, ready to be released into the world. Shit's going to be ridiculous. Havoc, what is happening? No wheelchair deaths. Well, you never know. One of the on the Kickstarters, one of the tiers was to be able to play as a wheelchair counselor. But see, that's, you know, that is a lot of money in and of itself, because now you have to have a Jason that can do a wheelchair kill with the axe, and it can't be just one kill, you know. And then it has to be like, you know, every different axe and weapon would have to be able to kill this one dude in the wheelchair. Like, that would be a lot of money. But it could happen. You never know down the road. How the hell, like, the wheelchair guy wouldn't be able to go in any cabins. Like, how the hell is he gonna, there's no wheelchair ramp. Like, maybe he can roll up the stairs? I don't know. Like, it takes a little extra effort to get up the stairs. Not down the stairs. He can go fast down the stairs. Maybe he gets a little bit of a boost going downstairs. So if he's exiting a cabin, my man can get a little boost going down some stairs. Hopefully he don't fucking fall sideways down the goddamn steps. Y'all. And then, but getting up the steps, not so much. Not so much. It would be fucking hilarious. Like, I would play another counselor just to babysit the wheelchair guy, just because I know he can't fucking get around that way. But I'm going to have to leave his ass. If he's just fucking, like, you guys, dude in the wheelchair, I can't save his ass all the time. If he is trying, he can try his best. But that is not going to keep Jason's axe out of his face. Like, I can't do nothing about that. So, that would be hilarious. You'd have to hide the wheelchair guy somewhere. Like, dude, just sit in the bathroom for a while, you know? He would have to have really nice stealth. Like, he would have to. Because, like, that's not fair. Dude can't even move that fast. He'd be the slowest fucking dude. Oh, man. Yeah, Mark. Randy's driving. And then that's the other question, you guys. If you're playing the wheelchair guy, how in the hell is he going to get into a car? Like, how the fuck's he going to... He would have to, like fucking... You guys, that would suck. If you get into a car, maybe you can get into a car, but then you can't get your wheelchair back. You leave your wheelchair to get into a car. So you decide to get into the fucking car as the wheelchair guy, you better hope that this person's going to get you away, because if you have to get back out of the car, which maybe the door would open and he would just kind of crawl out, then you're stuck crawling. Like, he's still fine and healthy, but now you're stuck fucking crawling unless you can get back to your fucking wheelchair, which is like fucking a half a mile away or some shit. Dude, the wheelchair guy would be no joke to play. Like, that would be for hardcore players. Like, fucking hardcore players that are just over it. They win so much. I'm going to play the wheelchair guy and win some rounds this way. Like, that would be pretty awesome. Still no news on the release date? No. The release date is still early 2017. Roof bungees? Oh my god, that would be amazing. Wolf Ninja said you attach the wheelchair to the car with a rope and maybe he can hang on and you can pull that bitch. Dude, that would be classic. You guys, if I saw the fucking car ride by with a motherfucking wheelchair dude just riding by. Dude, it's fucking like fucking flying on the back of the car and then you can detach it whenever you want. Holy shit, dude would be flying. And then his wheelchair goes rolling. What if he hits a log in the road? This bitch would go rolling down the road. Shit. Oh, the mental images. Holy shit. That would be the worst. Can you imagine, like, the wheelchair guy is attached to the back of the car and Jason throws a knife in his head? So then the car's still pulling him, thinking he's still alive. And then they're like, wait, he stopped talking. They look like maybe somebody turns their camera around if their passenger sees that the dude is dead with a knife in his head. Could you imagine that shit? Wow. Wheelchair guy needs to go in the game for real. Dude, that would be exciting as hell. Like, I would be down. I would totally try to live with him. Shit. The silver bullet? Like, he would have to have something to make him challenge. Like, Jason can't just walk up on him and kill him anytime he wants. Like, he has to have something. Something that makes him a little bit to where he can survive. I don't know what that would be. The Dragon early 2017 is actually not over until the end of this month is over, which is 10 more days. You never know, man. Make early 2017 will always be here. It will never leave you. Bell as soon as you see Jason. That would suck. Like, and the dude's like attached to the back of the car or something, and everybody just leaves and he's just like stuck wherever Jason appeared just then. That would suck. Like, everybody's running away. Here he's trying to fucking push himself as fast as he can. Wait, what is this? Oh.
Fuck you! Over.
Oh shit, do I have to show this? Let me show this.
I don't know what this is, but we're about to watch it.
Alright, let me turn off this music, y'all. I got sent a clip here. He is gonna bust his ass. That's what it's gonna be like right there. Oh my god! Oh my god. That's what it's gonna be like. Oh shit. That's the face Jason's gonna be making at Mark when he falls in the water, you guys. That is Jason be like, that's what happened to me. Maybe I should just leave it alone. Let it happen. Mark, can Mark, would he be able to swim?
What is it?
Just drown. That would suck. He just left him, like he just watches him die. He's like, damn. I am alive. Jason Voorhees saved me.
Just go and get some help.
Okay. Oh, that was the end of it. Oh my god. Okay, yes, exactly. Exactly. Yeah, I think the wheelchair, I think Mark would like fit in somehow pretty well. Okay. So that, I think we covered it for wheelchair dude. Like, he's like, let me drown. There would be a lot of things though. Like, how would he get through doors and like all this other shit? Cause he's almost like a transport vehicle, but in, like, he's a counselor with a little mini transport vehicle. And he can't go anywhere. He can't run or use his legs at all. So that's it. Can you imagine if Mark rolled up on Jason and just hit him with something? And then just rolled away?
Shit.
He hits him, knocks him out, slowly turns his fucking wheelchair around and rolls away. Just slowly. I'm going like an old man. Oh, shit. He wouldn't be able to go that damn slow, though. He'd have to have some kind of speed. Oh, shit. There's just all these mental images. Mark just rolls up on another counselor. I'll save you! I'll save you! He rolls up behind them. Slap. Rolls away. The other person gets away. Wheelchair Jason? No, I don't know. No, we couldn't do that to Jason, you guys. Can't do these things to Jason. It is inappropriate. All right, Rough Flow Dog. Thanks for popping in. Have a good night. The wheelchair is Jason's only weakness. That's how you kill him. Run him over with the wheelchair. Somebody has to fucking knock him out. And then wheelchair guy slowly, bam, run over his ass and then he dies. That's how you kill them, you guys. Who's the seven members out of the Scooby-Doo counselor gang? I don't know. I mean, like, it's weird because she's dressed like, kind of like, how Velma would dress, but she would be Daphne. But Flirty Girl looks like Daphne, but she's wearing the wrong kind of clothes. And then Chad is obviously trying to be, I don't know what Chad's trying to be. See, here's Velma right here. She needs to have, oh my god, she just needs Velma clothes. Bam, Velma. You guys, that would be amazing. Deborah Kim needs the Velma clothes on, I'm telling you. Because there is somebody I know named Velma that plays on Steam. And they play on that, they play the game that Randy just played, White Noise. And you can make a Velma character on there, it's amazing. I think it's probably be more than one person that rolls on there as Velma. Yeah, the bookish girl is Velma. Who is, Chad is Fred Jones? I don't know if Chad is Fred. Fred's a leader. Chad is, I mean, he does kind of dress like Fred, but Chad is not a leader. I don't know if Fred was really a leader anyway. He just kind of like, see, that's Fred right here. He's just wearing the wrong clothes. Let me take Chad's clothes and put them on Tommy Jarvis. And then, there, then you can have Fred. Jinkies. It was funny, you guys. Me and Avenger were playing White Noise, and Velma rolled up in there. We weren't expecting it. Like, just somebody randomly named Velma in there, and then we saw their character in-game, and they looked exactly like Velma. They changed the colors. And then I was like, dude. And then, like, just randomly in the match, something scary happened. Like, we heard a scary noise. We all paused, And then up in the text box, in the chat box, it said Jinkies with exclamation points. And we busted out laughing. That shit was, it was, we busted out me. It was amazing. It was funny as shit. Yes, Evil Wax, you must stop playing The Division and start playing Friday the 13th when it rolls out, definitely. Do you think Stalk will last longer in the Tom Savini, Jason? I have no idea, Killer Chris. We will have to figure that out once release happens. Everybody in the chat room wants a release, you guys. And I'm not talking about that kind of release. I don't know, maybe it is. Killer Chris just says, I don't care. I just want to scare people. See, that's the cool thing about playing Jason, is you know when you're coming up on somebody, you won't hear the same music they're hearing. But you know, like, if you fucking stay in character and you're playing well, you know you're scaring the shit out of somebody. And that's the thing you got to realize is you're scaring people. If you roll up on somebody in a house, you can probably leave and then come back. That person's going to stay in that cabin for a little bit. They're not going to get in and just leave. They don't know whether you're stalking or not, you know? You just got to kind of play mind games with people. And you could probably be a really good Jason. Jason's basement is awesome. Do you guys have any questions? I know you guys want to see the reveal again. For those of you just popping up in here and you haven't seen it yet, I will play it again. This will be a quick cabin night. I know everybody was hyped about it. They wanted to talk. They had to get it out of their system. Killer Chris, you have stalking practice? You did? Well, shit. Gob, look at Gob noticing more stuff. Gob said, did you see that when you search a drawer, it stays open? There it is. Gob noticing some stuff, you guys. Take notes. All right, let me throw it back up. Pulling it back up. Right now. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's mine. That's the wrong one. Sorry about that. Pulled up the wrong video. Go back. There we go. Hold on. It went back to my own site. There we go. Now I'm back. Here we go.
Hi, I'm Tom Savini, and I'm here to introduce you to a world-exclusive video of the new Jason I created for the Friday the 13th game. That's not it. You ready? Here it comes.
Majestic Bone said that painting doesn't belong above a toilet. Icy Bear, what is up? Welcome back. Don't talk back. Fucking epic, you guys. Pretty freaking epic. That's not even the entire track, you guys. Imagine when you're running from them for about, you know, 2-3 minutes. Then you're going to hear the whole track and shit's going to get wild. Shit is going to get wild. Cooley Dives, did you just pee your pants? You will have to clean that up. You guys, we will end the cabin chat right there. This shit's pretty epic. There's going to be a lot of people scaring a lot of people. Mr. T, everybody that's rolling up in the chat room right now, let's get some shout outs before we head out of here. I'm going to put a couple of songs on for you guys. This is the Crispin Freeman. Crispin Freeman. Crispin Glover. The Crispin Glover dance. It is Love is a Lie by Lion, and I'm trying to find Crispin Glover so he can say hi. Oh, here we go. Breeze Knees, thanks a lot, man. Yeah, we hit 3,000 followers, you guys. Awesome sauce. We are growing steadily. Very nice. The community is growing. We're going to have lots of fun very soon. Peace.